And if we keep on going, moving every constraint up to the highest point it will go, we get this. And now I checked, and the original version of the puzzle that I set running is still running. And now I can hit run on this. And in less than a second, I see my result. 1-5, meaning water is drunk in house number 1, and the zebra is owned in house number 5. So this is an amazing thing. It's as if we had a car race, and we had the start here, and the finish someplace far away, and we had this competitor car, which was the original zebra puzzle car. We'll call him Z for zebra. And we said go, and it started out down the path towards the finish. We wanted to build a competitor to that, but we just let it go. It's running, and we're thinking, and we're analyzing, and we're not doing anything, and it's getting farther and farther ahead and closer to the finish line. And maybe we spent half an hour, and it's halfway through. It's gotten up to this point. We're still stuck at the start sign. But what we're doing is we're building a better car. We're building a super fast race car, and we're putting the pieces together using what we know. And eventually, this car has gotten a long ways along the way, and then we say, now we're ready to go. And when we hit go, zoom, we're there in less than a second. What took this car, who had the half hour head start, is not even close. So it's like the tortoise and the hare, only in reverse. And by thinking and coming up with a better design, we were able to beat this original design, even though we gave him a half hour head start. So we won the race. We get the checkered flag. We should be happy at what we've done, and congratulations. Now, if you're the type who just cares about winning the race and finishing first, we can stop here. But if you're a little bit more analytic and you like to know the exact scores and times, then we've got work to do. Here's one thing I can do. There's a module in Python called time. In that module, there's a function called clock, which gives you the time of day. And so I can set T0 to be the time before I call the zebra puzzle, T1 to be the time afterwards, and just return the difference. So that'll tell me how long the zebra puzzle took. If I hit run, the answer it came back with was 0.0 seconds, and that's because the system I'm running on doesn't have an accurate enough clock. And I know it's accurate down to the thousandth of a second, so all we can say here is that it took less than a thousandth of a second. And I've run it on other systems, and it comes back at 0.00028 on that other system. Now, I was able to do this, but this looks like a good opportunity for generalization. Why do I want a function that only times the zebra puzzle? It'd be great if I had a function that could time the execution of any function. So here I've defined a function called timeCall, which takes another function as input, sets up the clock, calls that function, calls the clock again to figure out the time, and tells me what the elapsed time is. So I could call timeCall of zebra puzzle to get the answer of how long that took, or I can apply this to any function. So I built a useful tool that I can use again and again. Now I can make it even more useful by doing two things. One is saving up the result and returning that as a second value, in case we're interested both in the result and in how long it took. And secondly, allowing functions that take arguments. Now you may not have seen this notation before, so let's talk about it for a second.